Morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Arvindan. Okay, all of you all have turned your book to page number 95.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this lesson is about conjunctions. What do you mean by conjunctions, children? What are conjunctions? Who can tell me?
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Umar.
Ma'am, words that join other words, ma'am.
Very good. A word which joins either two words or two sentences are called as conjunctions. Joining words are called as conjunctions. Okay. Few examples of the word of conjunctions are and, but, or, yet, because. Okay, all these are all conjunctions.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. Okay, now Okay, now take your grammar books, turn your book to page number 95. Okay, the ones you'll have too much of noise behind, please sit separately where you do not have too much of noise. It's disturbing the others in the class.
Page number 95, no ma'am?
Yes, page number 95, worksheet 2. Okay. Page number 95, worksheet 2.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am. Okay, now I'll read what is given here. Read the sentences given below and note the words that are highlighted. The old man walked quickly, yet he was not tired. Okay, though the old man walked quickly, he was not tired. Generally, when we walk fast, we become very tired, right?
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
The old man walked quickly, yet he was not tired. Second sentence, you can drink tea or coffee in the evening. Okay, so here the words that are highlighted, these are the words, these are the conjunctions which are joining two sentences. The old man walked quickly is one sentence. He was not tired is the second sentence. So with they have joined both the sentence using yet.
Yet.
Okay. So the old man walked quickly, yet he was not tired.
Tired.
Same way here, or is being used to join the sentence. You can drink tea or coffee in the evening. Okay. So yet and or are conjunctions. Fun to know and easy to understand. Yet shows a contrast between two statements. Okay, what do you mean by contrast? Something like opposite. Okay, see, though he walked quickly here, he was still not tired. The general thing is when you walk fast, so you do work, continuously keep doing work, most of us will feel tired, right? But here it is opposite. Though he walked fast, he was not tired. So yet is used or yet shows a contrast between two statements. He worked hard, yet he did not win a prize. Okay, everyone works hard, but does everyone get first rank in the class? No. Okay, the same way. That does not mean that the rest of them are not working hard. Everyone is putting their effort in studying, okay, to get a first place, but then it does not happen. Okay, next one. She is poor, yet she is happy. Okay, do you understand the contrast here? Though she is poor, she does not have everything, but still she is happy.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Page number, ma'am?
Page number 95. Okay, next one, all expresses a choice or an alternative. Okay, like here you see, you can drink tea or coffee. Okay, you can either drink tea or if you want, you can drink coffee. Okay, we will go to the park or the zoo on Sunday. You have a choice to make where you want to go. You can eat a pizza or a sandwich. Here also you have a choice. It doesn't mean that you have to eat both. You can choose between pizza or a sandwich. Okay, do you all understand when yet and or is used? Yet is used the two statements
are
in contrast with each other, and or is used to choose between this or that. Okay, now fill in the blanks with yet or. First sentence, He was tired dash he kept working. What will come? Yet or or?
Yet.
Very good. Answer is yet. Everyone write Y-E-T, yet. Okay. He was tired yet he kept working. Okay. All of you have written?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Next. Second one. Jane must have the medicine dash she will fall in.
Or.
If you don't have the medicine, you will fall sick. Okay. So.
Ma'am, first one not, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. You have to use yet or only. Okay. So Jane must have the medicine or she will fall ill. Okay. Next third one. Krish can go swimming dash he can play cricket.
Mama.
Or.
Very good.
Or ma'am.
Is or. Over. Or.
Finish ma'am.
Okay. Now turn your book to the next page. Page number 96.
Up one, ma'am.
Page number 96. Okay, fourth sentence. You can use a pen dash a pencil to write the answer.
Or, ma'am.
Or, very good. Right, so are or.
Finish, ma'am.
O R or.
Finish, ma'am.
Fifth one. The little girl was hot dash she was smiling.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, though she was hurt, she was still smiling. So it is yes.
Yes,
the little girl was hurt, yet she was smiling. Okay, all of you are finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, next fifth one. He left early, dash he missed the train. He left early, yet he missed the train. Okay. Next step, next seventh one. You can go to Kolkata by train.
Or.
You can go by train.
Or, ma'am.
Okay, next eighth one. The players tried their best. Dash they lost the match.
Yet, ma'am.
Okay, all of you have written?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, next ninth one. Harish will have an egg dash a glass of milk.
Or, ma'am.
Yes. Ninth one. Okay. Harish will have an egg or a glass of milk. Tenth one. The sun was shining brightly. Dash he felt cold.
Yet, ma'am.
Okay, the sun was shining brightly, yet he felt cold.
Finished, ma'am.
Okay, all of you have finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now next one, B. Fill in the blanks with and, but, yet, or. You have to fill in with these words. First one, Suresh will go to the shop. Dash, Jane will go to the shop. Suresh will go or Jane will go. There is a choice here. Okay, so the answer is? Second one, we walk to the top of the hill, dash look down.
And ma'am.
And ma'am.
And.
Second one is and.
And.
Okay, second one is and. Next, third one. Veena tried her best. Dash, she could not solve the problem.
But ma'am.
Here she's putting her effort.
Yet, ma'am.
Okay, Veena tried her best, yet she could not solve the problem. Okay, when you compare two things, then you use but. Okay, like in the fourth one, Neeta is short, Dash, her cousin is tall.
But her cousin is tall.
B-U-T, but. Yes, Umar,
ma'am.
Umar, you have a doubt?
No, ma'am.
Oh. Next, fifth one. The boys cleaned the room. Dash decorated it.
And ma'am.
Fifth one is and. Okay. Next, sixth one. They waited for the guests. Dash did not come.
But ma'am.
Right. B-U-T. But. Okay. Everyone is written?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Next. Seventh one. She is pretty. Dash. She is foolish. But.
Or ma'am.
Yes.
It's not or, it is but. B-U-T. But she is foolish. Okay, next case one. Please have a glass of water. Dash a cup of tea.
Or.
Very good. It is or. Or a cup of tea.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, next. Okay, ninth
ma'am,
one.
What is eighth one, ma'am?
Eighth one is or. O-R, or. Okay. Next, ninth one. Neeta danced. Dash, Nisha sang a song.
And, ma'am.
Very good. And. Ninth one is and.
And.
Finish, ma'am.
Ninth one is and. Next, 10th one. The story was funny. Dash, nobody laughed.
But, ma'am.
But.
Right?
But, ma'am.
Yes. Okay, all of you have finished till here?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you all have any doubts in this?
This 10th one, ma'am.
10th one is but. B-U-T, but.
But. Hey. Ma'am, so... any of the words that join two words or sentences is called
conjunctions. The words which join two sentences or two words are called as conjunctions. Okay?
Ma'am, but I don't understand what
this one. Ma'am, one.
Sorry. One, yes, one at a time. Yes, Aaron, I'll come back to you, Umar.
Ma'am, I didn't understand why but and yet don't.
They also join the sentences, right? See, if you take the last one, the story was funny, but nobody laughed. Okay, if you have to split the sentence into two, it will say, the story was funny, the second sentence will be, nobody laughed. So when you're going to join these two, you're using the word, but. Okay?
But yet also you can use, no ma'am?
Yes.
Yet
also you can use. The story was funny, yet nobody laughed.
Ma'am, we are writing this down also, ma'am.
The down one, y'all can just give. Y'all can do it on your own now. Umar?
Ma'am, what is eighth one? Ma'am,
eighth one is or.
Ma'am?
Eighth one is or. O-R, or.
Ma'am, when is final exam timetable is coming, ma'am?
Oh, once we get it from the management, we will let you know.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so as of now, we've not got any information on that. Okay, now I have already given you the portions. Please start studying. From our next English class onwards, you will be having revision. Okay,
yes, ma'am.
So hereafter, on Fridays, you will not be having English class. Yes. Is that clear?
And
only on Mondays,
yes,
you will have. Yes,
Friday. Great test, ma'am.
You will have, it will be online exam only that you will be having. You will have to write like the way you all did for SA1. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. 5 subjects, 5 days you will have. Okay? So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, these 3 papers will be submitted by any one of your parents. Only one parent. No students are allowed in the school. Okay? Children should not come to school 3 days. Okay. Now, on Wednesday, you'll have to submit 3 papers, and Friday, you will have to submit 2 papers. Okay. We do not know the dates as of now. So, once the dates are given, we will let you know.